And welcome to The One Show with Alex Jones.
And Matt Baker.
Now, everybody loves a wedding, isn't that right?
No, I hate them. I don't mind a good funeral, but I can't bear weddings.
How can you?
Oh, I call that enforced joviality and loads of kids running round in bridesmaids' frocks and, oh, posing for photos every 10 seconds and buying presents they don't want and, oh, you have to trek miles and go and stay in some lousy B&B some wedding in the middle of nowhere. No, I don't. Don't invite me to your wedding. Your funeral, I'll turn up.
Put your fingers in your ears for this next film,
don't
then.
Don't invite Paul. Yeah. For those of us who do like a wedding, here's how to capture the moment.
Oh,
perfectly.
I hate them.
Weddings. For those involved, having great photos of the big day is vitally important.
So we get professionals in to do the job, but what is it that makes their photos of your big day look more professional than Uncle Bob's snaps?
Sean Gannon is one of the best wedding photographers in the business.
We'll look for the light and we'll look for the emotion and we'll look for the interaction between people, and we could do it with a smartphone or a compact camera.
Today, I'm riding shotgun to watch him at work. First, Peter, the nervous groom. Sean finds a spot where he can control the light.
So how come you've closed the curtains?
Rather than wrapping them completely in light, I want to get just a nice definition between the light side of his face here and the shadow on this side. So by closing the curtains down, I'm just reducing the light down ever so slightly.
The narrow shaft of light draws the eye to Peter, with the background receding into relative darkness. Next, a group shot with Peter's mates.
Can you rest up on there like that? Yeah, that's good. What we're trying to do is break up the lines. We don't want them all standing in a straight line, hands in pockets, looking normal. We're trying to keep a bit of a diamond formation going.
The shot is posed, but it appears completely natural, the hallmark of a real pro. It's all go. We have less than an hour to photograph Laura, the bride, getting into her dress.
The bride going into the dress is something that a lot of girls dream of from very early age, and it's a key moment to get.
It's the details that are important, like the lacing of the corset.
What we're going to do now is get some really nice portraits of Laura. What I can see now is what Peter's going to see when she walks down the aisle, so I want him to be able to remember that both in his mind and in photographic form.
Again, Sean controls the light by drawing the curtains. And to prove that this works just as well on a camera phone...
Perfect.
Sean is constantly looking for unusual angles and using devices like reflections to get something a bit different. In the ceremony itself, Sean makes sure he gets all the important moments without getting in the way. After the service, Sean has the couple to himself. This walk allows for some lovely intimate shots in a stunning environment. He's constantly directing the couple.
Go up there. Practice your first dance for me.
Oh, no.
Just like that, it's perfect. There's no one here. What we have here is an aperture in the gate, which is giving us a lovely framing for some nice moments of the two of them.
When the conditions take a turn for the worst, he turns it into an opportunity.
It's horrible, it's pouring down, but getting them running through the rain is just fantastic.
Formal group shots can be challenging. People tend to line up stiffly and it's hard work getting them relaxed.
All the boys think it's a free kick. So boys, wouldn't mind putting your hands behind your backs. Let's get you all turned in as well. So you bring that shoulder in, that shoulder in. What I'm going to try and do is have everybody turn two-thirds in. Mm. It's just a little bit more flattering. It also brings everyone together and looks like the family. If you stand people normally, they'll stand about this far apart. Even the two have just got married.
In the late evening, when things get more informal, Sean gets those shots that make a wedding a wedding.
If there's one thing I've learnt about wedding photography today, it's that you can't afford to hang around on the outside looking in. You've got to be right in the middle of things, in the action, seeing potential photographs and making them happen.
And Sean did make it happen. This is a set of photographs that will be treasured for a lifetime.
Oh, that one's lovely, isn't it?
Great film.
And that tip about pretending to dance.
Yeah, that was good. And the curtains, yeah.
Brilliant.
There you are, next time you go.
Still hasn't moved me, though. I just see him as a nuisance. Oh, well, before you...
Anyway, thanks to all of our guests tonight. Look out for Paul and his dogs on ITV1.
Yeah, tomorrow we're joined by Hugh Fearnley Whittingstall. You'll see you at 7.
Good night.
Bye.
Thanks, Paul.